Hi, hello viewers, it's my Minute IAS Academy. Today we are going to discuss about Cholas of Tanju. Here we have seen Gagatwalas of Kanauj. Then we have seen important dynasties in Kashmir. We have seen Thomas of Delhi, Chandelas of Bundelkhand. Now we are going to see Cholas of Tanjore. Cholas of Tanjore, their period is from 9th century to 12th century. Cholas of Tanjore can be divided into three stages. First stage is Sangam Cholas, which we have seen in our ancient India. In ancient India, we have seen Sangam Age. In Sangam Age, we have discussed about Cheras, Cholas and Pandyas. In this medieval India, we will discuss about the intermediate Cholas as well as later Cholas. Intermediate Cholas period is from 850 to 1000, around 1000. So later Cholas period is from 1000 to 1200. So earlier Cholas will have capital at Tanjore. Later they will change it to Gangaikonda Cholapuram. The important rulers of Cholas are Rajaraja Chola as well as Rajendra Chola. Both are the most important rulers of Cholas. Then around 856 AD, after 856 AD only, they will attain prominence. After 856 AD, they attain prominence, which means during intermediate Cholas only, they will attain prominence. And entire area around Tungabhadra, Tungabhadra is a river, entire area around Tungabhadra river will be united by this Cholas for around a period of 200 years. For around 200 years, they will unite this entire Tungabhadra region within their control. And these are the importance of Cholas. And another important fact is Cholas are strong in navy, which we have already discussed during ancient India. Cholas are strong in navy. They are also strong in foreign trade. And Cholas extended up to Sri Lanka. They will conquer Sri Lanka and Maldives. Sri Lanka and Maldives are not in our country now, right now. So, but then they will capture the Sri Lanka as well as Maldives. This show their strong navy power. So these are the things which are relating to Cholas. Cholas will become prominent in South and Southeast Asia. So let us discuss this in details. So as I already said, they are strong in navy. And actually, Cholas will be in South India, right? So most of them, they will have a sea route. They will have a sea boundary. So because of protecting that sea boundary, they will have a strong navy. This is one importance. They occupied Sri Lanka as well as Maldives. Let us discuss the important rulers. First one is Rajaraja Chola as well as Rajendra Chola. Let us discuss about them. First one is Rajendra Chola. So Rajendra Chola, he took some military expeditions. He took some military invasions to Ganges. So Rajendra Chola is the one who took military expeditions or military invasions to Ganges. So he will be defeating the Ganga ruler. He will take military expedition to Ganges and he will also defeat the Ganga ruler. After defeating the Ganga ruler only, he will attain the title as Gangaikonda Cholapuram. He will attain the title of Gangaikonda Cholapuram. And by the beginning of the 13th century, Pandyas became more powerful and Cholas became big. By the beginning of that, I have seen their period. I have already said their period as Cholas from 9th to 12th century. By the beginning of 13th century, Pandyas will emerge as more powerful. Because of that, Cholas will become weaker. So Chola patronized Tamil literature, architecture, and also they also are good in economic activity. So they patronized for Tamil literature and architecture. They are good in economic activity because of their sea trade. They did foreign trade. They are very excellent in foreign trade. And we have discussed three stages. And Rajaraja Chola as well as Rajendra Chola, which are seen as important rulers, is from later Cholas. They are from later Cholas. So relating Sangam Cholas, we don't need to gain so much points. We have discussed all this in ancient India. In Sangam Age, Urayur or Tiruchi is the business capital. Urayur is in Tiruchi is the business capital. And Kaveri Pumbatinam is also one capital. Kaveri Pumbatinam is the capital. Urayur Tiruchi is the business capital. These are the things which are relating to Sangam Cholas. Then we have Imperial Cholas. Imperial Cholas period is from 850 to 1000, we can say. In Imperial Chola period only, Sri Lanka is conquered. Sri Lanka came under the Chola territory. So during Imperial Cholas, the capital is Tanjore. Tanjore is the capital and one important ruler is Aditya Chola. Aditya Chola is an important ruler during the Imperial Cholas. He caused the demise of Pallavas and he also defeated Pandyas and occupied major part of the Karnataka. He caused demise of Pallavas and he also defeated Pandyas and he occupied major part of Karnataka. this one importance. And during Imperial Chola itself, we have another one ruler called as Parantaka Chola 1. Parantaka Chola 1 also comes under the Imperial Chola. During Parantaka Chola 1, there will be a fight with Rashtrakutas. Parantaka Chola 1 is the son of Aditya Chola 1. He conquered Sri Lanka. He is the one who conquered Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is conquered by Parantaka Chola 1. And during this period, Rashtrakutas of Malkel will attack the Cholas and Cholas will lose some territories. So, Rashtrakutas of Malkel, we will discuss about Rashtrakutas of Malkel during the tripartite struggle. So, Rashtrakutas of Malkel will attack Cholas and Cholas will lose some territories during the Parantaka Chola 1. During Parantaka Chola 1, only Sri Lanka is conquered. Then we have Parantaka Chola 2. Parantaka Chola 2 regained the territories which they lost to Rashtrakutas. So during Rashtrakutas, they will be losing some territories, right, which will be regained by Parantaka Chola 2. The age of Imperial Cholas is considered as the golden age of Tamil literature. The Tamil literature flourished during the Imperial Chola period. From 850 to 1200, the Tamil literature flourished. So these are the things which are relating to Imperial Cholas. Then we will discuss about the later Cholas. So relating Parantaka Chola to, he conquered the territories which they lost from Rashtrakutas. Then we have later Cholas. The founder is Kulathunga Chola. Founder is Kulathunga Chola 1 and the last ruler is Kulathunga Chola 3. Last ruler, here is Kulathunga Chola 1, last one is Kulathunga Chola 3. So Kulathunga Chola 3 conquered Kalinga. Kulathunga Chola 3 is the one who conquered Kalinga. And in 1180, Chola King lost the control of Venki to Western Chalukyas and Gangavadi to Hoysalas. So, they will lose the control of Venki to Western Chalukyas. In 1118, they lost the control of Venki to Western Chalukyas. Important ruler is Rajaraja Chola 2 comes during this period only. Rajendra Chola, Rajaraja Chola, everything comes during later Chola only. First, let us discuss about the temples. There is a temple, three temples called as Trinity. These three come under World Heritage Site. They are Airavateshwara Temple, Brahadishwara Temple and Gangaikonda Cholapuram. Airavateshwara Temple. So first one is Airavateshwara Temple. Airavateshwara Temple is at Dharasuram. So it is at Dharasuram. Then we have Brahadishwara Temple, or big temple, which is at Tanjore. Then we have another temple called Gangaikonda Cholapuram. These three are the most important temples relating to Cholas. This Airavateshwara Temple will be built by Rajaraja Chola 2 and Brahadishwara Temple will be built by Rajaraja Chola 1 and Gangaikonda Cholapuram will be built by Rajendra Chola 1. These are the most important temples which are relating to Cholas, and these three temples comes under Trinity and all these three are World Heritage Sites. And River Kaveri is also called as, so River Kaveri. There is a River Kaveri. River Kaveri is called as River Ponni. So because of its importance, it is called as Ponni. Ponni means it is something related to gold. It is called as Golden River. River Kaveri is called as Golden River by this Cholas because of the importance of this River Kaveri. It is a special place of culture of Cholas. In the culture of Cholas, River Kaveri is a special place. And Rajaraja Chola 2. Rajaraja Chola 2 period is from 1146 to 1175 AD. As like I already said, he is the one who built Airavateshwara Temple at Dharasuram. Then most important ports. There are two important ports during Cholas. One is Kaveri Pumbatinam. We have discussed it during Sangamage Cholas itself. Kaveri Pumbatinam, which is in Kaveri, in the river of Kaveri. Then we have Nagapattinam. So Nagapattinam and Kaveri Pumbatinam are the two important ports. In this ports, Roman coins are found. So it implies that they had trade with Romans. So from Kaveri Pumbatinam as well as from Nagapattinam or foreign trade centers. So from this ports, there are foreign trade flourished, and this is depicted by using Roman coins. Roman coins are found from these ports and relating to Cholas administration. Let us see about Chola's administration in our next video. Thank you. Subscribe to My Lemonade IAS Academy.